Hotel Infinity, Part 5. Recap. You run a hotel with an infinite number of rooms. When the rooms are full, you can still accommodate new guests, even if they arrive in an infinite number of infinitely large groups. But one day a new kind of group arrives. Flat creatures from another world, stacked together like cards in a deck. There's one creature for every number from 0 to 1. Is it possible to make room for them? The answer, it turns out, is no. It can't be done. But it takes you a while to accept this reality. Your guests check out, leaving your hotel empty. But you and your colleagues rack your brains all day, struggling to find a solution. You find many ways to fill the hotel with people. But somehow, all of these attempts leave an infinite number of visitors unhoused. In fact, no matter what you do, the stack of people seems undented. You can tell that certain individuals are missing, but the group as a whole seems undiminished by your efforts. You gaze upon this stack of people, all named after numbers. Their names have decimal expansions with an infinite number of digits. They are so well organized. They all have a 10th digit, and a 100th digit, and a 1,000th digit, and so on. Some of their names are too long to be spoken in this world, as Zero said. But can you put those names in some kind of order, nonetheless? Assigning someone to room 1, someone else to room 2, someone else to room 3. Then you inhale sharply. No, you say. It can't be done. It can never be done. No matter how smart we are, no matter how many tricks we think up, it's impossible. Don't give up yet, the president says. Perseverance never fails. It'll fail this time, you say. I'll show you. You grab your intercom and announce to every room at once. Announcement. Hotel Infinity is happy to welcome you to our world, but I must ask a favor of you. Please, look at your room number. Let's call it N. And then look at your own name. Find the digit N places after the decimal point. Remember, N is your room number. Take the digit you get and paint it on the wall in the hallway right by your door. Your guests comply, and soon your hotel wall is painted with an endless string of digits, stretching as far as the eye can see. And now, dear guests, you say, please do one more thing for me. Look at the digit you've just written, and then think of a different one. Not a 9 or a 0, I don't want any of that 0.9 repeating shenanigans, but any other digit is fair game, as long as it's different from the one you have. And now, if you would be so kind, please write that new digit on the carpet, right in front of your door. Your guests do as you ask. You mark decimal points at the beginning of the hall, and soon there are two infinitely long decimal numbers written in your hotel, one on the wall and one on the floor. You point to the number on the floor and say to your colleagues, "This number written here is the name of one of our visitors, a visitor who doesn't yet have a room." "Are you sure?" says the scientist. "They might have a room. Let me just check my notes." "Oh, hello there," says a single creature who had apparently approached unnoticed. "I couldn't help but notice that you wrote my name on your floor. That's very flattering. And no, I don't have a room yet. Do you think one will open up soon?" "Wait, how did you know this individual wasn't already in your hotel?" the coach interjects. "Was it magic?" "No, it wasn't magic. Look, visitor. May I call you visitor for short? Are you sure you aren't the guest staying in room 1? Maybe it just slipped your mind." "No, I'm positive," says visitor. "Look, it says right there, the guest in this room has a 7 as their first digit. My first digit is most certainly not a 7. And I'm clearly not staying in room 2 either," says visitor. "The guest in this room has a 3 as their second digit. I can assure you my second digit is not a 3. "You see," you say to the scientist, the coach, and the president, "visitor can't be the guest staying in any room for similar reasons. The guest in room 10 has a 6 as their 10th digit, and visitor does not. The guest in room 100 has a 2 as their 100th digit, and visitor does not." "I see," says the president solemnly. "No matter how we fill the hotel with creatures, there will always be at least one left out. It's completely unavoidable, because a hotel full of creatures can always write down the name of someone who's missing." "That would suggest," says the scientist, "that there are in fact more creatures here than there are rooms in your hotel. The rooms in your hotel are infinite, yes, but the creatures here are more infinite, a different kind of infinity, so large that your infinity seems minuscule in comparison." "We have no choice, then," says the president. "We need to turn them away. There isn't room for them here." But you raise your head, and you meet her eyes.
No, you say.
We don't need to turn them away. We need to build a bigger hotel.
That doesn't seem practical, says the coach. There's nothing wrong with acknowledging your limitations.
This isn't about that, you say. At Hotel Infinity, there's room for everyone. What is the point of even doing this if we don't welcome everyone? What is the point of doing this if we keep people out?
The president speaks. Very well, she says. We'll help you build it.
It may take a new kind of building, a new kind of thought, a new kind of world. But we'll try it and see what happens. And that's how there came to be a second Hotel Infinity. The second, but perhaps not the last.